reading, writing, sorry. So I want to start recording now. So like we did the other day, it's going to be 40 minutes, then after which would go off, come back again. Please just bear with us. So that's how I'm going to, do it. So we're sharing. Okay. Now, we're starting with writing. Now, writing task two. Writing task two. Sorry for that. Let's get writing task two. Now, in writing, let's understand there are several writing types. There are several essay types, especially in writing task two, but and different teachers, school of thought have different categorization. And I also have my own categorization. But the long and short of it, the bottom line should be that you should be able to respond to any question, regardless of whatever categorization it's coming under. So the first thing, oh my God, Mr. Ahmed.
Sir.
Mr. Ahmed, can you please put your microphone on mute? We are getting feedback from you.
Okay.
Thank you. So, now the first thing is I call one argumentative essay. Argumentative. Or some people call it argumentative argument. So let's just call it argument. And some people prefer to call it opinion essay. Opinion essay. I'm trying to, because I cannot put away the fact that there are some of us who have actually probably been with some teachers before or use online resources. So, and if you have used online resources, you will understand all these discrepancies in categorization of writing essays. So some people call this opinion essay, some people call it argument. So whichever one you're saying, you call it, is the same thing. Now, what is opinion essay? That is the kind of essay where they are expecting, where you are expected, expected to argue out a particular stance point. That's just a point. So they ask you to argue out a particular stance or point. You take a stance on one side, against the other side. So now usually this argument or opinion gives you two sides, so to speak. It gives you a two-sided essay, and they're expecting you to stand on one side or argue out for one side. Now, the argument is not like what we used to do in primary and secondary school, where they say, well, we used to do debate. No, we are not doing debate. This is an essay, and it is an argument. So, but we are still going to stay on one side. There are similarity between with that debate we did in secondary school then, where we were supposed to, say why one is better than the other. So it's like that here, but we'll not use all these. I'm here to support the motion, accurate timekeeper, good debaters, and all of those other things that are usually usually obtained in those ones. We are not going to use that, but we are just going to stay, give out a point, staying on one side. Now, for me, as far as I'm concerned, there are different variations in this one. There are different variations. The variation number one, okay, is the opinion essay itself. Opinion essay, where people, you get questions like, what do you think? Do you think? What is your opinion? what is your opinion? So you have that, you know, that those questions like that. Now, the second variation, the reason why I put all of this in, because they tend to have the same, almost the same type, the same feeling or the same approach. Or they tend to have almost the same, the emphasis is on almost the same. So we have the agree or disagree. Or disagree. So they give you, let's say, for example, they ask you, they just bring out a sentence. So let's see, let's say a typical question here. The typical question here, what is your opinion? The typically IELTS has several ways of coining your question. This is one of them. Some people believe that is okay, elementary, okay, that it is better to introduce children early enough to foreign language. I might have to restructure that so that we can get some people believe that it is better to introduce children okay, let's remove this one. Children to foreign language in elementary school. While others believe it should be she'll be in secondary school. Then the question goes, what is your opinion? You would have my sniffing and probably coughing intermittently during the class. So I apologize in advance. I think I have a flu, so apologies for that. So that's a typical question. So let's see, under this one, we'll have the same question being refurbished, okay? Because the kind of pattern you have under agree or disagree is quite different from what you have under the typical argumentative essay or opinion essay. So let's see. You have what the same question, the best time to introduce foreign language to children is in elementary school. You're gonna have it like that. Is the elementary school full stop? Do you agree or disagree? And it could go as far as and not the secondary school. Do you agree or disagree? You have that's the second type of argumentative essay, the second variation, as far as I'm concerned. Because we can, if we by the end of the day, you find out that we have about close to 12 variations and counting, actually. 12 variations and counting. But if you are not very, what's it called now? It means that we have to put so much in our head. So that's why I try to put them under the same subcategory, different subcategories, so that it's easy for us to adopt one approach for all of them. So do you agree or disagree? We have that one. So you have, there's a third one where they say, to what extent do you agree or disagree? And it goes, to what extent do you agree or disagree? Okay. Now, let's be very careful here. Now, when they say to what extent do you agree or disagree, they can actually be, in this case, you have agree or disagree. But here, there can actually be only I'm trying to admit those people who are waiting in the region. Okay. So they can actually be four possible stances, and it could be agree. Please, as soon as you come on board, please mute your microphone. Thank you very much. So you could have agree to a large extent, or basically you say, I totally agree. Totally, absolutely agree. Possible. The synonyms of total, absolutely, completely. So we have that. You could have, that's a stance. You could have another stance where it's agree to some extent. Agree to some extent. Okay. Sorry, I'm trying to get someone in. Message. Right, stay with me. Sorry. So let's continue. Sorry. Okay. Okay. So let's continue. Sorry for that break. So agree to some extent. And on the other end too, you could have disagree, but on the very extreme, disagree to some extent. To a large extent here. Then on this other, on the midway, and midway, you could have agree to should be disagreed on. We have disagreed to some extent. Now, so you have those are the four instances that you could have. Now, you know, the difference between this question and that question would just be that they add the agree, do you agree to some extent? That's just the difference. It's almost the same thing. Whereas this one has two possible stances, this one is going to have four possible stances. Now, let me say this. These stances are all valid. But in my years of experience, I always tell my students to stay away from the middle point. And I'll tell you what I mean by that. What are the middle points? What are the middle points? The middle points are these two. So I'm going to try to strike them through. Disagree to some extent. I'm striking them through. What I'm saying in essence is that don't go there. Reason being that it says you should maintain a middle ground. These two that I've stricken out is always requiring you that you maintain a middle ground. And maintaining a middle ground means that you will have to talk about the two. Now, sometimes, I'm sure some of you have heard teachers, whether online, whether black or white, you have heard when they say, any essay you want to write, maintain, always talk about the other side before you go back, move for the side that you favor. I don't belong to that school of thought. They would say, if you use some online resources, they would say, you have to, first of all, talk about the side that you don't agree. Let's say, for example, I am in this case now. In either of this case, I'm not talking about this number three alone. In any of this, they usually say that argumentative essay, whether argumentative or disagree, or to what extent you agree, you should talk about the side that you don't agree first or you don't go for. So if in this case I'm going for the fact that I disagree that children should be allowed to start learning foreign language from elementary school, I disagree with that. Now, if I disagree with that, some people would say, I will give reasons why some school of thought say that I'll first of all give reasons why some people will agree first before I go to my disagree. I don't buy that school of thought. I don't agree with that. What I agree with is that from the beginning, okay, I think we have issues with the volume. Okay, I'm trying to increase the volume. So. How about now? Let me see what I can do about the volume. So the volume is actually to the highest. So I don't know. Maybe you should check your own audio from your end. Then we can really. Please excuse me. Hello, sorry for that. So now some people, so from what they say that people should try as much as possible to talk about the other side before they get to begin to speak about the side that they favor. I don't subscribe to that. I really don't subscribe to that because more often than not, students get to, handle it roughly. They tend to, you know, make a mess of that essay. So, and this is actually where it is very, very, very necessary. This C is actually where it is very, very necessary to, if you stay in between, to talk about the two sides. Because to some extent means a little bit to the others to the left and a little bit to the right. So you are in between. So, but then if you agree, you are going to be agreeing more, but then to some extent, but your agreement is the major thing. If you disagree, you are going to be disagreeing. Disagreeing is your major thing, but you are going to have to agree that your disagree is the major thing, but you still have to talk about why the reasons why some people may agree if disagree is your major. So these are the but I don't give my students that opportunity to stay on either of the what's it called now? To stay in between. I want them to stay on the extremes. Stay on the extremes so that you don't make a mess of it. Okay. Now what you can do that because IELTS isn't such an exam where they are written something. There is a pre-planned what's it called now? Where there's a pre-planned answer. Okay, that you have to conform to. It is not WAEC. If there are 1,000 students or scripts, IELTS is expecting 1,000 different stances or different approach, different content. And may I say that IELTS is quite frowns at plagiarism, copying other materials. But then I'll prefer that in this case you stay on the extremes. You can agree to a large extent or agree to a large extent. And to a large extent, totally agree or totally disagree, absolutely agree or absolutely disagree, and the rest of them like that. Now, going forward, there's also a D, okay? Now, these D, your D and E actually have different variations. They have different variations, different variations. So I'm going to talk about that. Now you have one where they say, is it, they ask you, is it a positive or negative development? Negative development. Now, is it a positive or negative development? For example, they say, for example, you have questions like, it has been observed that many stores are closing down due to the emergence of online stores, okay? Then that's a sentence. Then they ask you, is it a positive? Is this a positive or negative development? So you have that variation. Now, I think this is clear enough. You have that variation. Now, you also have a variation where they ask you, under this variation, you have another variation. So we can say this is D1 actually. Actually, we can say this is D1. Let's just put the one here, DI. DI, then there's a 2. Okay, now this 2 is when they ask you a question. It's still negative or positive element, but there is a variation to it. So permit me to quickly copy that. Then it goes, do the negative to the. So let's paste that. The positives outweigh. The positives outweigh negative. So the positive of this, positives of this outweigh the negative. Okay, let's remove the S. Whichever whether it says or not. So do the positive outweigh the negative. Now you could have that's a variation. Sorry, apologies for that. Now do the positive outweigh the negative. Now that's a typical question type. So the same question is what we're going to use there. Okay. Remove this. The negative. The negative outweigh the positive. So you have that. Question variation. That means there are two variations under that one. So you have to understand. Now, what is the difference between the two? They are not saying here in the D1, they are saying they are positive or negative. They are saying, you tell us, is it positive or negative? That's what they are saying. Tell us, in your own opinion, is it positive or negative? But in this D2, you will find out that that question has a subtle, what's it called now? How do I put it now? Subtle acknowledgement, that's the word I'm looking for. Subtle acknowledgement that both exist, but they are telling us, in your own opinion, which one is higher. So you are going to, by your right up, show us which one is higher, while acknowledging the side that you don't want to go for. Side one, let's say you say that it has more positives, but you are not saying then as against negative, more positive against negative. But you are going to acknowledge that there are positives. You must acknowledge that they are positive before you go ahead to talk about it. And you must acknowledge that they are negative, sorry, before you go ahead to talk about your positive. If you are saying there are more negatives, you must acknowledge some positive area. Must, the pretty word is must. You must acknowledge that there are positives before you go ahead to talk about the negative. Now, here, there are two ways about it. We will talk about that in subsequent classes. As soon as we are done with all these types of essay, Our major focus today, God willing, is we'll be talking about opinion essay. We'll talk about opinion essay, basically. Now, the fifth variation under this also has an I and a one and a two. So here you have advantages and disadvantages. Advantages and disadvantages. Now, make sure you pay attention to pluralization. If in the exam, you have the word advantages and you go ahead to write advantage one, you would not have scored very well in task achievement. You will not be doing very well with task achievement because here there's a subtle indication of pluralization. So you can't write one advantages and one disadvantages and say you are done. There's a subtle understanding, indication of plural. So you have to pluralize whatever points. It has to be 2 points that you are bringing in. Okay, so some people are saying they can't hear me. All right. It's what? So the audio is working. Please check from your end if it is working appropriately. From my end is okay. So permit us to quickly, maybe we should go by, yes. Could you please tell us why, what your question is? Unmute your speaker, ma'am. Hello, Shimon. Okay, I think so. Maybe we should move on. Let's move on. So, advantages and disadvantages. Now, let's take the same question that we have under this space, and because they have almost the same thing in common. The same question, let's put it, let's have it down here. I'm not saying, these are just for example purposes anyway, so if you understand. Okay. So you have I. Let's take this one. Please, if you are just joining, kindly mute your microphone from your end. If you are just joining, please mute your microphone from your end. Mute your microphone from your end, please. Okay. All right. Okay. So I think this is a convenient time for us to go off so that we don't get jammed off. So please rejoin as soon as we go off. Kindly rejoin. Thank you very much. Sorry.